Hello everyone, Matt Trepfer here with NTS Tire Supply, and today we're talking about something that is certainly out of the ordinary, and that is planting with LSW Super Singles. This past growing season, we tracked and analyzed two unique planting setups that each used the LSW Super Singles on the planting tractor. One tractor had the LSW 1040R32 tires on the front and 1145R46 tires on the rear, and the other had the 1135R32 tires on the front and the 1430R46 tires on the rear. We followed the effects of these two machines from planting through the growing season to see firsthand what their impact is on soil compaction, final stand establishment, plant and root development, and ultimately yield for both corn and soybeans. In order to get a fair analysis of these tires, we partnered with AgRevival Research and had Nate Furley, the founder and chief agronomist, help us collect the data in the field and analyze the plants growing in the LSW tire track and compare those with plants growing outside the tire track. The results from these two tire setups were substantially different from one another. One setup delivered very good results, while the other did not perform as well. Today, I'm going to shed some light on LSW Super Singles by sharing five things that we learned about planting with these massive tires. Before I go any further, there are two things you need to know. The first is that the weather this past growing season was poor. We had an overabundance of rain, so any sort of compaction from equipment showed up in all the fields. The second is that this study compares the effects of the LSW tires where they have driven to where there's been no traffic and no compaction whatsoever. The purpose of doing this is to quantify the impact that the tire track had when planting. With that said, let's get started. To start, let's talk about stand establishment. When we looked at the final stand for soybeans in the LSW tire track, there didn't appear to be any reduction under average growing conditions. In very wet areas of the field that were under high stress, we did notice a roughly 5% reduction in stand in very localized areas. The cause of the stand reduction wasn't from plants not emerging after planting, but rather from phytophthora, which causes soybean plants to die in season in high compaction, low oxygen, wet areas of the field.
So just walking along here, you know, this is another one of those environments where seeing some plant carcasses here, phytophthora, and when we push the meter down, you know, 3 inches we get a little bit of resistance, and then 220, then we can blow through. So this one took 225 pounds of pressure to come through off of the tire track as well.
In corn, there was no identifiable difference between planting into the tire track and planting away from any tire track when it came to the final stand. Point number two, plant and root development. I'm going to talk about soybeans first. With the 1100 LSW setup, there was no significant difference between plants growing in the tire track and those growing outside the tire track. It took a very careful examination of the plants to notice any differences.
Root mass, very similar, good penetration on the deep tap, and nice lateral branching. Typically on a soybean, if we see a compaction layer at that 2 to 4 inch mark, you won't see a lot of this. You won't see those lateral branches up in that zone. Typically that taproot will go through it, and then you'll see almost like a wall of lateral branching that go underneath that hard pan. Looking at the two in comparison as evaluating roots, I would say there's no difference in them between planting into the tire track versus planting outside of the tire track.
When we analyzed the corn plants, the results were very similar, with the plants growing outside the tire track showing a slight advantage.
So just got back from in the field, looking at the two plants again. We've got this root mass here from the row not planted onto the tire track. This row here is what was planted onto the tire, and we still see the same thing. We're getting a lot of lateral movement before we're going down. Typically what we see between duals or between in a pinch row setting is that you may not have less root mass, but you'll have a little bit tighter. These guys will start to shoot straight down through a lot of that upper root mass. They won't have that nice lateral branch to them. So I'm impressed with that. Looking at the root mass sizes, you know, where we're not planting on the row width or on the row tire, it does look better. A little bit more of a root mass structure to the top. Looks like a little bit more aggression to those nodal roots. So, but very impressed with what we're seeing there.
The 1400 LSW tire setup showed different results. With that tire setup, we saw some reduction in vegetative growth and root development for both corn and soybeans under average field conditions. In wetter areas of the field, the negative impact from the tire tracks was more prominent. We could see that the roots weren't penetrating and branching out in the soil quite as well. The root systems in the tire track tended to be flatter and stay more towards the surface of the soil, and the plants were stunted, and we could see that they were behind a little bit in maturity. Using a drone, we could see the tire tracks going through the wet spots, and we could also see that the final stand was thinned out more in those areas compared to others. In the most severe cases, we saw the final stand drop from 126,000 plants per acre outside the tire track to 46,000 inside the tire track for soybeans, and go from 35,000 outside the tire track to 31,000 inside the tire track on corn. However, we didn't see the same kind of negative impact with the 1100 LSWs. So what was the reason? Air pressure. And that brings us to point number three, tire air pressure. The tractor with the 1100 LSWs weighed around 26,000 pounds, which meant the tire pressure could be set at 8 psi in the front tires and 12 psi in the rear tires. The tractor with the 1400 LSWs, on the other hand, weighed in at a hefty 48,000 pounds on just the rear axle. It had a total gross weight of 60,000 pounds when just 60% full of seed and fertilizer. This meant that the tires needed to be inflated to 13 psi in the front and 25 psi in the back, roughly double the air pressure in the rear tires when compared with the 1100 LSW setup. When you increase your tire air pressure, the footprint size of the tire decreases, putting more weight on a given area. And the impact from running a higher air pressure showed up in the corn and soybean plant's ability to grow both above ground and below in the 1400 LSW tire setup. Point number four, compaction. In talking about compaction, I'm going to focus on what we saw with the 1100 LSW tire setup, which was running at a lower tire air pressure. If you want to see the compaction measurements for the 1400 LSW tire setup, I'll leave a link in the description so you can view that information. Immediately following the planter pass, we took compaction meter readings at 3, 6, and 9 inches. Outside the tire track in average areas of the field, the compaction measurements showed approximately 25, 115, and 140 pounds per square inch respectively. Inside the tire track, we measured 120, 140, and 150 psi. To put these numbers into perspective, root growth is obstructed at 200 psi. So as you can see, the compaction levels were higher in the tire track at 3 inches, but they weren't high enough to impede root growth. Also, the difference in compaction levels between inside and outside the tire track narrowed as we moved down through the soil profile until there was no difference between the two. Interestingly enough, over the course of the growing season, the difference between the compaction levels in the upper soil profile narrowed up a bit. So overall, planting into the 1100 LSW tire track does not stop root development, and that is supported by the corn and soybean plants we dug and analyzed later in the season. And our last point, yield. The 1400 LSW tire setup actually had the same kernel counts inside and outside of the tire track under average growing conditions. However, there is still going to be a yield drop because of the reduction in final stand for both corn and soybeans. Also, the corn growing in the tire track had lighter, shallower kernels. However, with the 1100 LSW setup, there was no difference in the kernel counts on corn or in the plant development on soybeans. From what we could tell, the pinch row effect that is common with duals and central fill planters was for the most part alleviated. Side-by-side trials performed in Iowa in 2016 showed the 1100 LSW Super Singles having a 6 bushel per acre advantage on soybeans and a 5 bushel per acre advantage on corn over a traditional dual setup. Based on what we saw this growing season, I would say that results similar to those are certainly possible when you have the right air pressure. After looking at these tires and studying their effects, both Nate and I were very impressed with the performance of the 1100 LSWs. Again, that was the tire setup that ran at a lower air pressure.
Coming into this, you think of what we see in headlands. Planting on top of a tire track, you think, well, I'm gonna see reduced in vegetative growth, tighter soils, maybe prone to more diseases. You can see it all year, especially in soybeans. That was what was in my head coming into this, but yep. Going out in the soybean field, taking a look, there's nothing indicating that there's a negative effect to planting on top of that tire. And the similar thing in the corn, if anything in the corn, I liked the way that root mass looked when we planted on top of that row. Typically in a dual situation, you'll have that pinch and you'll stress that plant a little more than what we saw here. So, you know, if I were to guess on the corn, yeah, we'll see a yield increase over the standard setup on the tractor.
If you're going to plant with LSW Super Singles, regardless if you have 1400s or 1100s, make sure that you're able to keep the tire air pressure below 15 PSI. If you're above that, you're probably better off staying with duals or triples. And remember that not all planting setups are the same, and there are a lot of factors to keep in mind when deciding whether or not to plant with LSW Super Singles. So if you have questions about this study or about the tires involved, or if you're considering switching yourselves, be sure to reach out to us. Give us a call, we'll be happy to talk with you. I want to give a big thanks to Nate Furley and AgRevival Research for helping us with this study. If you haven't already, I highly encourage you to check out their research. They test a variety of products, practices, and equipment on corn and soybeans here in Minnesota. All of their studies are replicated across multiple locations. What's even better is that all of the data, including yield and return on investment, is available to growers for free. So if you're looking to maximize the ROI in your agronomy programs, they are an excellent resource. If you like this video, be sure to hit that thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. And don't forget to turn on notifications so you don't miss out on new content. Thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next video.